A smart nation, smart cities is something that I think that everyone has a role to play in.
I think a smart nation is one where there's the necessary infrastructure in place for knowledge to be discovered and transferred autonomously.
So a smart city is the epitome of how the offline and online worlds converge. At this stage, it's very important for us as a business to be able to have a good understanding of what is the potential applications of these technologies.
When technology is working properly, it should seem like magic. It should get your attention because it seems amazing, and amazing not just because it's clever and smart and sounds cool, but because it's actually super useful for you.
You know, I've seen companies like in healthcare, in urban planning, and I see some of the advancements in smart machines and the deployment. Kind of gives me a little bit of hope that, you know, at a more societal level, I see the application of smart machines and helping drive perhaps a more equal quality of life for more people rather than just a few. So I think that gives me a bit of optimism, how we see smart machines being deployed.
And so the way that we can start to use all the properties that we have access to, all the communications we have access to, and all the data together to understand where you are, why you're doing what you're doing, deliver things that surprise and delight you at every moment, wherever you are, and are truly useful and not just annoying. That's where I think, you know, the definition of, we actually change the definition of advertising itself.
I think there are forecasts that by 2020, the whole industry of VR and AR is going to be worth $120 billion. And it's still a very nascent industry. There are some early adopters, entertainment, education and gaming, and a lot of focus is on applications.
VR で実現したことって、今までと違って実現したことっていうのは、まず一方的にものを見る、見せられるとか、そういうことではなくて、ユーザーが視点を自由に移動できるっていうことが一つ大きなことかなと。VR っていうのは今はエンターテインメントっていうふうなところで活用されてるんですけど、ここ数年でですね、おそらくコミュニケーションツールっていうふうなものになっていくんじゃないのかなと思います。
Cool technology plus brand logo is not an idea. If Co-Driver was just VR plus Chevy, then it's not a great idea. But if it is bringing the best possible test drive experience to every dealership and every motor show, well, that's something that we know we can work towards.
The current hardware is not perfect. The bulky hardware doesn't really appeal to a lot of users. But I believe one day we'll have the killer design, like how the smartphone has went along its journey to its current day. So I think by then, mass adoption will be a lot more widespread.
Immersive content is never really meant to replace real life. I think the way we strike balance is really how we do it with any other aspects of our lives. It's all about boundaries and choices. You have to respect a person's right to choose. You do have to think about how they want to interact with the piece of content, who they want to interact with, and basically just take the best decisions when you're actually creating that content to respect that decision. Once we're able to do that, then I think what we are building is essentially balance in the content that we create.